This is a follow-up to a previous video where I showed how to create a lip and groove feature. It got me thinking about a challenge in creating a non-planar lip and groove. Let's dive right in. Looking at this housing, you can see that the top surface was not created in a flat, planar fashion. So how do we create a lip on such a surface? Perhaps we need to somehow create a 2D sketch and project that line onto the curved surface. I have prepared an offset plane above the housing. Let's create a sketch on this plane. We need to create a profile of the lip as seen from the top. First, we need to create a copy of the inner edge of the wall by going to create, project include, project. You can select the whole inner face and click OK. Go to offset. Select the projected lines and adjust according to how thick you need the lip to be. Finish the sketch. We shall use this outer sketch line to split the top surface of the housing. Activate the Surface tab, go to Modify, Split Face. Choose the curved surface as a face to split. For splitting tool, select the outer sketch line. We can see that the face has been split with a line down the middle. Now that we have this split face, it would make sense to try to raise the inner face up to create that step. I can think of maybe 3 ways to raise this up. Let's try the Extrude tool. So it seems that I am unable to select the face. The Extrude tool can only be used on planar faces. Let's try the Press Pull feature. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify. Press Pull. So it does allow me to select the face and even extrude. But there is a problem. The extrusion is happening in a direction that is normal to the existing face. This is clearly not going to work for us. In order for the top housing to be assembled, the lip needs to rise up vertically. So maybe we can try the offset face feature. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Again, we face the same problem as a Press Pull feature. Another problem with this method is the resulting uneven lip thickness due to the curvature of the face. Clearly, we need a different strategy here. Let's go back to the point before the split face was created. Unhide the previous sketch. Select this contour and start the Extrude tool. We shall create a lip starting from the sketch plane and terminating on the top face of the bottom housing. Drag the extrude in the general direction. For extent, choose Tool Object. Click on the curved face. Select the Chain Faces option to make sure that the extrude terminates properly on the uneven face. Hit OK. Looking at the cross section, we can see that now we have a lip that rises up vertically. But we do not want a flat face on top of the lip. We want it to follow the original curved face. Let's create a copy of that face. Let's roll back the timeline to before the extrude so that we can get a better view. Now that we are working with surfaces, let's activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Pick on this face and adjust it according to how high you need the lip to be. As you might have guessed by now, we want to be using this surface to cut away the excess of the lip. However, we are not ready to use this surface just yet. If we roll the timeline forward to review the extrude, you can see that the surface created by the offset feature might not have enough coverage. Let's roll back the timeline. To be on the safe side, we want to extend both the inside and outside edges of the surface. Go to Modify, Extend. Click on the inside and outside edges. Once done, drag the arrow. Fusion is able to extrapolate the surfaces naturally. We just have to extend the surface enough to cover the extrude. Roll the timeline forward to review the extrude. Go to Modify, Split Body. For body to split, select the main body. For splitting tool, select the surface. Once done, you can delete or simply hide the unnecessary bodies. There is actually an alternative way without splitting bodies. Let's use a relatively unknown feature called Replace Face. Activate the Solid tab, go to Modify, Replace Face. We are going to replace the top surface of the lip with this offset face. For source faces, that is the face we need to replace. So select that. For target faces, that is going to be the new face. So select the offset face. Hit OK. And hide the offset face. So without doing any splitting, we have created the same outcome.